الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى today بإذن الله الكريم we're going to go through the famous hadith that is called Hadith Bara ibn Azib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. This hadith, it talks about the grave and the people inside the grave. And so we're going to reflect over this hadith bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. Hadith Bara ibn Azib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. The hadith in its lengthy, it's found in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullahu ta'ala. Bara ibn Azib said, خرجنا مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. We went out with the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. We came out with the Prophet. So the companions رضي الله تعالى عنهم, may Allah be pleased with each and every one of them, they came out with the Prophet. And when they came out with the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام في جنازة, and they came out with him to a janazah. So they're with the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. فانتهينا إلى القبر, we came to a grave, and we came on top of a grave. فجلس رسول الله, the Prophet sat down عليه الصلاة والسلام, وجلسنا حوله, and we sat around him. And this shows you the etiquettes and the manners of the companions, how they were. The Prophet sat down. He didn't have to tell them to sit down. They followed him even in his actions. So when the Prophet sat down, they all sat down with him, alayhi salatu wasalam. وَجَلَسْنَا حَوْلَهُ, we sat around him, alayhi salatu wasalam. وَكَأَنَّ عَلَى رُؤُوسِنَا الطَّيْرِ, it was as though, the narration says, birds were on our heads. And the reason why the companion said, كَأَنَّ عَلَى رُؤُوسِنَا الطَّيْرِ, it's as though birds are on our head, is لِشِدَّةِ سُكُونِهِمْ وَوَقَارِهِمْ, how tranquil and how calm the companions were. They were not moving around. So if a bird stands on something or it stays on somewhere, it's an object that doesn't move, right? A bird won't stand on something that moves. If the thing moves, the bird flies away. And this is the etiquette of how the companions were attentive when it came to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, and how they listened to him. كَأَنَّ عَلَى رُؤُوسِنَا الطَّيْرِ, it was as though birds were on our heads. وَفِي يَدِهِ, in the Prophet's hand. The Prophet had inside his, on his, in his hand, عُودٌ يَنْكُتُ فِي الْأَرْضِ, the Prophet, he had with him a twig. And the Prophet was scribbling on the earth. And he was doing this for a period of time. And the companions were quiet. And they were waiting and listening to him in silence, just watching what he was doing. فَرَفَعَ رَأْسَهُ, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he lifted his head up. فَقَالَ, the first thing he said to them was, استعيذوا بالله, seek refuge in Allah من عذاب القبر. The first thing that the Prophet said to them was, استعيذوا بالله, seek refuge in Allah من عذاب القبر, from the punishment of the grave. مرتين أو ثلاثا, the Prophet, he said this twice, at least, or three. So he said, استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر, استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر, استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر, seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave, seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave, seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. He said this twice or three times. This benefits us how the companions were very reliable. The narrator, or the scholars who would narrate hadith, how reliable they were. That if they were doubtful about a matter, they would transmit the doubt. They would say twice or three times if they're not sure. They won't dismiss that difference. To be precise in when they convey the narration. ثُمَّ قَالَ, then the Prophet said after that, إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ, verily the slave, الْمُؤْمِنَ, the believing slave, the one who believes in Allah, who believes in the Day of Judgment, who comes with righteous actions, إِذَا كَانَ فِي انْقِطَاعٍ مِّنَ الدُّنْيَا. So now the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's going to tell us the first group of people. When it comes to this world, the people are either believers or they are non-believers. So the Prophet starts with the believers. He says to us, alayhi salatu wasalam, inna al-abd al-mu'min, the believer who is what? A true believer. Brothers and sisters, iman is not a claim. Iman is not just a mere claim. Rather, iman is ma waqara fil qalb wa saddaqatu al amal. It is what settles into your heart, and then your limbs tell the truth about it. It manifests on your limbs. So when the Prophet says here, innal mu'mina, innal abd al mu'mina, the believing slave, he means the one who iman has settled into his heart and has also come with righteous actions. That individual, إِذَا كَانَ فِي انْقِطَاعٍ مِّنَ الدُّنْيَا, when he's departing from this earth, he's leaving this world, and he's leaving it, which is going to be the situation of everybody. That moment, that transition, where this person is leaving this world, وَإِقْبَالٍ مِّنَ الْآخِرَةِ, and they are coming to the hereafter. Going to your grave is the first manzil min manazil yawm al-qiyamah. It is the first station from the stations of the hereafter. That's why Uthman, whenever he would come to a grave, he would cry, hatta yabulla lihyata, until his beard would be filled up with his tears. And they said to him, Uthman, tudhkaru al-jannata wal-nar, the jannah is mentioned, the nar is mentioned, فَلَا تَبْكِي, you don't cry. And then when you come to the grave, you cry until your beard is filled up with tears. And he said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say that the qabr is the first stage. It's the first manzil min manazil yawm al-qiyamah. It is the first station from the stations of the hereafter. If the person makes it through the grave, and he wins, and he answers the question, and he passes, and he passes the test, then he's verily going to pass everything after that. But if he fails in the grave, then he's verily going to fail in every stage that comes after it. This is where the stage is. So the Prophet said, إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ الْمُؤْمِنَ إِذَا كَانَ فِي انْقِطَاعٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَإِقْبَالٍ مِنَ الْآخِرَةِ نَزَلَ إِلَيْهِ مَلَائِكَةٌ. The angels will descend on him. The angels, they will descend on this person. He's about to leave this world. He's dying. The nafs has been taken out of him. The angels, they come down on him. بِيضُ الْوُجُوهِ. جزاك الله خيراً. إِذَا كَانَ فِي قِطَاعٍ مِّنَ الدُّنْيَا. If the person is leaving this world and he's facing towards the hereafter, نَزَلَ إِلَيْهِ مَلَائِكَ. Angels descend on that person. The appearance of these angels are بِيضُ الْوُجُوهِ. Their faces are white. كَأَنَّ وُجُوهَهُمُ الشَّمْسِ, is like their faces is the sun. Is like their faces is the sun. مَعَهُمْ, with these angels is كَفَنٌ مِّنْ أَكْفَانِ الْجَنَّةِ, a shroud from the shrouds of Jannah. The shroud is taken from Jannah. وَحَنُوطٌ مِّنْ حَنُوطِ الْجَنَّةِ, and the fragrance that the shroud is made of is what? It's also brought from Jannah. حَتَّى يَجْلِسُوا مِنْهُ مَدَّ الْبَصَرِ, Now these angels will sit from him as far as his eyes can see. They don't do nothing. ثُمَّ يَجِيءُ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ Then the angel of death comes. عليه السلام حَتَّى يَجْلِسَ عِنْدَ رَأْسِهِ The angel of death will then sit on the person next to their head. فَيَقُولُ He would say, يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةُ O you righteous soul, O you noble individual, أُخْرُجِي Come out. إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانِ Come out to the forgiveness and the pleasing of your Lord. فَتَخْرُجُ It comes out, the nafs comes out. تَسِيلُ كَمَا تَسِيلُ الْقَطْرَةِ مِنْ فِي السِّقَاءِ The nafs comes out of the person the way that the water goes through the kettle and it just pours out easily. It doesn't struggle, it just comes out, pours out easily. If you do that, it comes out. فَيَأْخُذُهَا The angel of death will grab the nafs. فَإِذَا أَخَذَهَا When the angel of death grabs the nafs, لَمْ يَدَعُوهَا He does not leave it فِي يَدِهِ طَرْفَةَ عَيْنٍ For a split second. He places it inside the kafan, the shroud. That smells nice. He placed the nafs in there. وَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا And then the angels that were sitting there waiting for the nafs to come out, place it inside the shroud, and then they go up with it. وَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا And they leave with it. كَأَطْيَبِ نَفْحَةٍ And it is the most pleasing smell there ever is. The greatest misk that you would ever come across, this is the greatest smell. وُجِدَ عَلَى وَجْهِ الْأَرْضِ قَالَ فَيَسْعَدُونَ بِهَا Then they go up and they ascend high and high with the nafs inside the shroud. فَلَا يَمُرُّونَ Those angels, they do not go by any sama عَلَى مَلَئٍ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ Every sama that they go, there are angels there. They don't pass a group of angels with this nafs in the shroud. Except they say, ما هذا? What is this? الروح الطيبة. What's this amazing, noble smell? What is this good soul? فيقولون, they say, فلان ابن فلان. This is so and so. بأحسن أسمائه. They refer to him by the best of his names. الذي كانوا يسمون بها في الدنيا. The best name that he used to be called when he was in the dunya. حتى ينتهوا بها until they bring him to إلى سماء الدنيا until they bring him to the stage where it distinguishes between the dunya and the hereafter. They come to the سماء الدنيا. This is the place where no one can go beyond this. Permission has to be sought. So they come to this. فيستفتحون بها فَيَسْتَفْتِحُونَ لَهُ They ask if the door of the sama can be opened for him. فَيُفْتَحُ لَهُ Then the door will be open. فَيُشَيِّعُهُ مِنْ كُلِّ سَمَاءٍ مُقَرِّبُهَا Every sama, the angels that are there, they actually join in with this nafs and they go to the next level and the next level and the next level. Until they come to إلى السماء السابعة the seventh سماء فيقول الله عز وجل Allah then says اكتبوا write كتاب عبدي write my slave this individual write this particular individual write him in the book في عليين the book for the noble righteous slaves وأعيدوه إلى الأرض and take his nafs back to his body take it back to his body فيأتيه ملكان then the nafs is then brought back to the person all of this is happening and the family are washing the body they are what? They are washing the body. They are preparing the body. They are taking the body to the grave. As soon as he's placed inside the grave, فَيَأْتِيهِ مَلَكَانِ, two angels come to him. As soon as he gets placed in the grave, two angels come to him. فَيُجْلِسَانِهِ, they tell him, sit up. They tell the man or the woman to sit up. And he sits up in his grave. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ, the angels say to him, مَنْ رَبُّكَ, who is your Lord? فَيَقُولُ, he says, رَبِّي اللَّهُ, my Lord is Allah. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ, then they say to him, مَا دِينُكَ, what's your religion? فَيَقُولُ, he says, دِينِي الْإِسْلَامِ, my religion is Islam. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ, then they say to him, مَا هَذَا الرَّجُلُ, مَا هَذَا الرَّجُلُ, who is this man الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ, that was sent amongst you? فَيَقُولُ, he says, هو رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. فيقولان له, then they say to him, وما علمك, where did this knowledge come to you that he's a prophet and a messenger from Allah? فيقول, he says, قرأت كتاب الله, I read the book of Allah. فآمنت به, I believed in it, وصدقت, and I took it on board. I lived by it. It governed my life. فَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ, a caller will then call out. This is after all the questions were put to him, and he had answered all of the questions. A caller will call out, and then he will say, أَنْ صَدَقَ عَبْدِي, my slave has told the truth. He has uttered words of truth. فَأَفْرِشُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ, so widen for him in Jannah. وَأَلْبِسُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ, and clothe him clothing from Jannah. وَافْتَحُوا لَهُ بَابًا مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ, and open for him a door from Jannah. قَالَ فَيَأْتِيهِ مِنْ رَوْحِهَا وَطِيبِهَا, the smell and the good fragrance of Jannah starts to come into his grave for him. وَيُفْصَحُ لَهُ فِي قَبْرِهِ, and then his grave gets opened wide for him. مَدَّ بَصَرِهِ, as far as his eyes can see. قَالَ وَيَأْتِيهِ رَجُلٌ, then comes to him a man. حَسَنُ الْوَجْهِ, his face is so beautiful. His image, حَسَنُ الْثِيَابِ, he's wearing good clothing. طَيِّبُ الْرِيحِ, the fragrance of this man is amazing. فَيَقُولُ, this man says to him in the grave, أَبْشِرْ بِالَّذِي يَسُرُّكَ, glad tidings in something that's going to bring you good. هَذَا يَوْمُكَ, this was the day you were, الَّذِي كُنْتَ تُوعَدْ, this was the day you used to be promised. This was the time you were promised. You were told that it's going to take place and that it's going to happen. فَيَقُولُ, this man says, لَهُ مَنْ أَنْتَ, who are you? The man in the grave looks at this beautiful man with the beautiful clothing and the beautiful face. He says to him, مَنْ أَنْتَ, who are you? فَوَجْهُكَ, your face is, الْوَجْهُ يَجِيءُ بِالْخَيْرِ, a face that will come with good. فَيَقُولُ, he then says to him, أَنَا عَمَلُكَ الصَّالِحِ, I am your righteous deeds. I am the good that you did when you were in this earth. The commands of Allah, you followed it. You stayed away from the prohibitions of Allah, even that though your nafs wanted it. You really wanted to do it. You wanted to sleep and not pray Fajr. But you reminded yourself of how serious it is. So you got up and you prayed. You realized the value and the importance of your parents and the station Allah gave them, and you obedient towards them. That's who I am. I'm a reflection of your righteous deeds. Now you ask yourself, brothers and sisters, this question. Who is the one that has stayed with you through everything? What is the one thing that's not left you, that's still with you right now at this point? What is it? Your deeds, good or bad. So that's what it is for you today. It's your deeds, it's your righteous actions that you need to carry. Everybody that day in that grave, when that image comes to you, and this is wallahi haqq, Nabiullah Muhammad as-sadiq al-masduq alladhi la yantiqu 'anil hawa in huwa illa wahyu yuha. He does not speak from his own whims and his desires. Everything he says is what? It's true, alayhi salatu wasalam. So that day, something is going to come to you. It's going to be good or it's going to be bad. If you're smart, if you're clever, if you're thinking well right now, today's your opportunity, sah. Today's your chance to make sure that news that comes to you is something that's going to please you. فَيَقُولُ, he says to him, أَنَا عَمَلُكَ الصَّالِحِ, I am your righteous deeds. فَيَقُولُ, this man, out of happiness, he passed the test. He passed the test. Have you guys not seen, those of you who've got license, who've got their license, when you pass the test, and the driver told you, you passed, you're going to receive your license. Some people, out of happiness, they hug the examiner. Some people, they, which I saw, they open the door, they walk out and say, let me take a deep breath. Sah? Some people, they lose it. Why? Because it just passed. What do you guys think? What would you think that day when you passed the real test? Sah? You've just answered. I've always said this. It's a question, it's a test. You know it's questions. And some people are still going to fail. It's a test. You know the questions that are going to be asked to you. مَا رَبُّكَ مَا نَبِيُّكَ وَمَا دِينُكَ. And there's people who are going to say, Imagine you fail a test. The question was told to you. It was already informed to you, and you went into that test and you failed. What would you consider yourself if you fail? Huh? That's the reality of the hereafter. We know the questions, and we even know the answers. We have everything. And there's still going to be a group of people who are going to fail. May Allah not make us from those people. Then the Prophet moves on to the second party of people. He says, وَإِنَّ الْعَبْدَ الْكَافِرِ, the disbeliever, إِذَا كَانَ فِي انْقِطَاعٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا, when he leaves this world, and he's departing from this world, وَإِقْبَالٍ مِنَ الْآخِرَةِ, and he comes to see the hereafter. That's why Ali ibn Abi Talib used to say a lot. He used to say, كُونُوا مِنْ أَبْنَاءِ آخِرَةِ وَلَا تَكُونُوا مِنْ أَبْنَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. Be from the people of the hereafter, and do not be from the people of this world. فَإِنَّ الْيَوْمَ عَمَلٌ وَغَدًا الْحِسَابِ. Today is actions. Just accumulate, do things. And tomorrow is what? Accountability. Tomorrow you're going to be accounted for those actions. So we have to take the hereafter and place it in front of our eyes and make sure that's something we remind ourselves all the time. Because that's where we're heading. So when the disbeliever, he leaves this world, he's leaving this world and he's going to the hereafter. نَزَلَ إِلَيْهِ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَلَائِكَ. Angels come down on him. سُودُ الْوُجُوهِ. Their faces are blackened. فَيَجِسُونَ مِنْهُ. They sit from him, those angels. مَدَّ الْبَصَرِ. As far as his eyes can see. ثُمَّ يَجِئُ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ. And then the angel of death comes. حَيَتَّى يَجْلِسَ عِنْدَ رَأْسِهِ. The angel of death, he sits right next to his head. فَيَقُولُ, he says to him, أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْخَبِيثَةِ, you filthy nafs, أُخْرُجِي, come out. إِلَى سَخَطٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ, come out to the anger, wa ghadabin. Come out to the anger of your Lord. Ukhruji, come out. Ila sakhatin min Allahi wa ghadab. The anger of your Lord. Fatufarraqu fi jasadihi. The nafs, because it doesn't want to come out, it starts to disperse inside the person. Fayantazi'uha. The angel will then be forced to bring it out forcefully. Kama yuntaza'u safud. The way that a metal rod is run through a cotton. If it's run through a wet cotton, can it run through it? La. Fayakhudhuha. The angel will grab it. فَإِذَا أَخَذَهَا. When he grabs it, لَمْ يَدَعُوهَا. He drags it. The person is screaming and it's burning and it's killing them. فَإِذَا أَخَذَهَا. When he grabs it, لَمْ يَدَعُوهَا فِي يَدِهِ. He does not keep it. The angel doesn't keep it. Of death doesn't keep it for too long. He passes it over to the other angels who are holding the shroud. And they place it, the nafs, inside there. When they place it inside there, وَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا. The smell that comes out from this nafs inside the shroud, كَأَنْتَنِ رِيحٍ. It smells worse than any bad smell that you've ever seen. It smells even worse than dead corpse. The smell of this nafs. فَيَصْعَدُونَ. They take it high up, they ascend with it. فَلَا يَمُرُّونَ بِهَا عَلَى مَلَئٍ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. They don't pass a group of angels. إِلَّا قَالُوا. Except these angels, they say, مَا هَذَا الرُّوحُ الْخَبِيثُ. What's this filthy soul? What's this filthy individual? فَيَقُولُونَ. They say, this is who? Fulan ibn Fulan. This is so and so. بِأَقْبَحِ أَسْمَائِهِ. They refer to him by the worst of his names. التي كان يسمى بها في الدنيا حتى ينتهى بها إلى السماء الدنيا. Until they come to the سماء الدنيا. They come to the سماء and they request for the door to be open. فلا يفتح له. The door will not be open. ثم قرأ رسول الله. Then the Prophet recited the verse. لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء وَلَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ حَتَّى يَلِجَ الْجَمَلُ فِي سَمِّ الْخِيَاطِ. That they would request for the door of the sama to be opened. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, لَا تُفَتَّحُ لَهُمْ أَبْوَابُ السَّمَاء. The door of the sama will not be opened for them. وَلَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ. And they will not enter Jannah, the disbelievers. حَتَّى يَلِجَ الْجَمَلُ فِي سَمِّ الْخِيَاطِ. Until the camel can go through a needle. Can a camel go through a needle? The same way that a camel cannot go through a needle is the same way that they cannot enter Jannah, and they will not also even be allowed to be taken through the sama'i dunya. They won't be. These angels won't open it for them. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that Allah says, "Uktubu kitabahum." Write this individual, his name, fi sijjin. Write it in the lowest rank, the evil criminals, wrongdoers. Write him in that book. Fil ardi sufla, which is in down deep the earth. The other believers, it was high up. It was high above. This one is low. فَتُطْرَحُ رُوحُ. And then once his name is written in the book, Sijjin, his nafs and his soul is then thrown into his body, thrown from the sama. And then the Prophet recited the ayah, وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ. Anyone who associates partners with Allah, فَكَأَنَّمَا خَرَّ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. Is as though he has been thrown from the sama. فَتَخْطَفُهُ الطَّيْرُ أَوْ تَهْوِي بِهِ الرِّيحُ. في مكان صحيق. On a windy day, like, the birds can snatch it. that person's nafs will be thrown into their body. And then once the nafs comes back to his body, the angels in the grave, they say to him, sit up. When he sits up, the two angels, they say to him, مَا رَبُّكْ, who's your Lord? فَيَقُولُ, he then says, ha, ha. And the reason why he would say that word, ha, ha, is the statement of, as Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali said, كَلِمَةً يُقَالُ, it's a speech that is said when the person is mutahayyir, confused. He doesn't know what to say. He's lost of words. He hasn't got the answer. And he said, لا أدري, I don't know. فيقولان له, then they say to him, ما دينك, what's your religion? فيقول, he says, ها ها, لا أدري. Then they say to him, ما هذا الرجل الذي بعث فيكم, who is this man that was brought out from amongst you? نبي الله محمد. فيقول, he then says, ها ها, لا أدري, I don't know. فينادي مناد من السماء, a caller will call out from the سماء, أن كذب عبدي, my slave is a liar. فأفرش له من النار, open for him a door for the hellfire to come in for him. وَافْتَحُ لَوْ بَابًا إِلَى النَّارِ وَيَأْتِيهِ مِنْ حَرِّهَا وَسُمُومِهَا, the heat of the hellfire and the torment of the hellfire comes to him in his grave. وَيُضَيَّقُ عَلَيْهِ قَبْرُهُ, and then the grave is then tightened on him. حَتَّى تَخْتَلِفَ فِيهِ أَضْرَاعُهُ, until his ribs, they cross by each other. وَيَأْتِيهِ رَجُلٌ قَبِيحَ الْوَجْهِ, this man was asked three simple questions. مَنْ رَبُّكْ وَمَا نَبِيُّكْ وَمَا دِينُكْ, he was asked and he was unable to answer those questions. And the reason why he was unable to answer those questions is because he didn't live by those questions, those answers. Some people think as long as they understand the information, that's it, they're going to be able to answer it. It's about living by those questions, what it entitles and what it means. So he would say, ha ha, la adri, I don't know. Then a man comes to him, قبيح الوجه, whose form is most ugliest, unappealing form that you would ever come across. قبيح الثياب, his garment, his outer garment, is also filthy and evil. منتن الريح, the odor and the smell that comes from this man is again devastating. فيقول, he would say to him, أبشر, glad tidings, بالذي يسوءك, on that which is going to harm you. Glad tidings for that which is going to make you suffer. And then he says to him, هذا يومك الذي كنت توعد, this was the day that used to be promised. It was the day that you were told about, you were informed of, that it is going to occur. فيقول, he then says, من أنت, who are you? فيقول, he says, من أنت, فوجهك الوجه يجيء بشر, it's a face that will come with no other good, it would only come with evil. That's the image and the form that you are. فيقول, he would then say, أنا عملك الخبيث, I am your filthy actions, all the evil that you did and the crimes and the wrongdoings that you did, that's what I am, I'm a reflection of that, I'm a manifestation of your evil action. فيقول, he would then say, ربي لا تقيم الساعة, oh Allah, do not let the hour come. The other one, what does he say? Allahumma aqim as-sa'ah. Oh Allah, the believer says, oh Allah, bring the hour. Hatta arji'a ila ahli wa mali, so I can go to my family and my money and my wealth. The believer, that's what he says. The disbeliever, on the other hand, he says, oh Allah, don't bring the hour. Why? Because what waits for him in the hereafter is far greater than what? Than what's taking place for him in the grave right now. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in a hadith, كنت نهيتكم عن زيارة القبور فزوروها فإنها تذكركم بالآخرة. I used to prohibit you from visiting the graves. I now instruct you and I command you to go and visit the graves. In another riwayah, the Prophet says, I instruct you, go and visit the graves. فإنها why? فإنها تذكركم بالآخرة. The grave will remind you of what? It will remind you of the hereafter. That's why I advise you brothers, if you can go and visit the graves. Peace Garden in East London. Go in it. Go and sometimes go inside it. Request if you can just go inside. And see inside it. That's one day going to be your house. The house that you're decorating in the UK today. And you're beautifying. And you're benefiting from the DFS offers. And you're bringing yourself the nice mattress. That hole is going to be your what? That hole is going to be your grave, your house. Can you beautify it? Can you decorate it? Yeah, you can. How can you decorate it? How can you beautify it? You can decorate it and beautify it with your righteous deeds. Look at this man. The grave is made for him so wide and so open, spacious. Today when the council wants to give you a, if the council, the council wants to give you a, Haringey Council wants to give you a house, what do you try to do? You try to go, you want to check it out. Are the bedrooms big? Is the living room good? Because guests are going to come to me sometimes. You want to check how the space of the house is, right? That's what you want to look at. If it's big, you like it, you say, mashallah, it's a nice house. It's very spacious, right? It's a big house. The grave is a place where you can make it spacious and big. But how can you make it spacious? With your righteous deeds. Brothers and sisters, you're going to be one of those two parties. I assure you that. Rest assured. You're going to be one of those two parties. You're either going to be العبد المؤمن, the true believer who came with what was required from him, or you're going to be from the other party. Brothers, work hard, put effort and hard work in. Everybody came to this world and people are working. Some people are working hard to make sure they beautify their house, and another group of people are not. Wake up and realize the reality of what waits us. Sahih, brothers? You guys are young, alhamdulillah. Fursa. Ni'matani maghbunu fihima kathiru minan nas. As-sihhat wal-faragh. Two blessings people are very heedless about. They only realize it once it goes. What is it? As-sihha, health. And al-faragh, free time. You guys have those two, right? You wake up every day, you're healthy. You got your body parts, you got your brain, you got everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also given you what? Free time. Those two are what makes you work hard. Those two. Free time and health should make you, it should be the thing that makes you come with amal salih. Because you're going to one time lose the shabab that you have, And you will look back at it one day. And you will say to yourself, later shababu ya'udu yawman. If only that time can come back again. And I can benefit from it. So now that you have that opportunity, and you're young, benefit from your time. If being on the streets and playing around and joking around would have benefited I can reassure you, you could see those who are on the street, have they benefited from their time? Have they? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, As-sa'idu man wu'idha bighayrihi. Smart one is. He doesn't have to necessarily be, the calamity doesn't have to befall him. He doesn't have to go through it. The smart and the successful person, he learns lessons through other people. When they go through it, he goes, alhamdulillah, I don't need to fall in it. But you know what's sad? Our youngsters, he's selling drugs. Before you, have you asked yourself, who was standing on this corner selling drugs? Have you wondered? He's either shot or he's either in prison. And the statistics of the chances of you getting caught is high or going behind bars, true or false? And then it's sad because there's another one right after you who wants, he's waiting for that position. And it's going on like that. So that person is not smart. You're not learning a lesson through what's happened to other people. You're going in the same ditch and the same hole as everybody else is going in. And you're being told, it's a T-junction, this road is closed, and you're still driving. You say, no, I want to check it for myself, I need to see it. Oh, it is a T-junction, oh, subhanAllah. And you drive backwards. That's the reality, wallahi, that's the truth. A lot of youngsters. I remember a brother, I said to him, Akhi, I advised him, I said, stop what you're doing. You're selling drugs, stop it, stop it. No, well, I swear, when I finish this, I make money, I'll stop. And you know what, I have to say something. A lot of the youngsters, I tell you this, this is a true statement, I say this with sincerity. Because I sit with the youngsters in the masjid, and I talk to them, and I tell them to bring me their friends, and we go out, we actually go out to them, local neighborhood, and we go into their little places, and we meet these kids. A lot of these kids, when you ask them, they say to you, I'm selling drugs. So why are you doing it for? I have to help my mom and dad. It's a lie. But the truth of the matter is, a lot of parents, they take from their kids who are selling drugs, they take the money from them. When you take the money from your child, what are you telling him? You're enforcing that idea into his head. You're making him believe that what he's doing is right. The truth of the matter, no one needs your money. The parents should say, I'm not going to take your money. Go away, leave. I don't need your money. Because he starts to think that he's a working man for his parents. And the Prophet told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, أَيُّ لَحْمٍ نَبَتَتْ عَلَى الْحَرَامِ فَالنَّارُ بِهِ أَوْلَى. Any flesh that has taken in haram, then the hellfire has rights over you. The hellfire will take its portion from you. That's why many of us, when we make dua, as the Prophet told us, رجل يطيل السفر أشعث أغبر يمد يديه إلى السماء يا رب ومطعم حرام وملبس حرام وغذي بالحرام فأنا يستجاب لهذا. He grew up on haram, he eats haram, he lives on haram. How is that person's dua going to be accepted? This is a traveler, he made dua in the middle of the desert, he's begging Allah. Are you with me? How is his dua going to be accepted? Yeah? How is dua going to be what? Accepted. I remember one time, one brother who sells drugs, we told him, stop, never listens. So what he did was, some of his friends, they ordered a pepperoni pizza for him. And so they had haram pepperoni on the pizza. So he what did he do? He started to take out the pepperoni and he said, SubhanAllah, stop. And he bought the pizza with the drug money. And he started to take the pepperoni out and he said, SubhanAllah, what are you guys doing? Why you give us haram for? Yeah? This is a problem, wallahi. And all of this is what? It's lack of tarbiyah and it's lack of nurturing and understanding the reality that awaits. The ones who are here, who come to these classes, come to these reminders, try to bring one person with you, or at least two. At least one person bring with you. Sah? The Prophet said, "Addalu ala al-khayri kafa'idi." If you bring one person with you, say, look, akhi, come, just listen. لا يهدي الله بك رجل واحد خير لك من حمر النعم. For Allah to guide one person on your hand is better for you than A lot of money is better for you than a red camel. Meaning, it's better for you than a Bugatti. So you bring a person you know on the streets, bad in the streets, bring them out. I always say to brothers, sometimes you see a person, Allah might guide them. You might not think to yourself, this person is ever going to come out from the darkness that they're in. They might come to the masjid, listen to a reminder. Then they like the reminder, or they like the lesson, or they like the talk, or whatever. And guess what? They become guided. And that person takes on themselves to go and seek knowledge. And they become a student of knowledge. And they graduate from a university. Huh? You guys probably know of a brother. His name is Sheikh Tahir White. Do you know him? Have you heard of him? Huh? Sheikh Tahir White. Sheikh Tahir White's African-American brother. He's the first English speaker who is permitted to teach in the Haram in English language. First English speaker who was given a microphone in the Haram, and he has a English language lesson in the Haram. Now he's a revert. He spent in Medina in the university the last 20 years studying. Somebody must have brought him into Islam, correct? Sah? Somebody brought him into Islam. What's the weight and the status of that person who brought him into Islam? The weight that they carry. Are we all together? So sometimes you may not accomplish a dream that you're looking for, but you might inspire a person, and that person may take it on. That person might become something. So that's why I say, bring somebody with you. Let them come to the reminders and the circle. They benefit. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would add that to your scale. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illallah astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.